Hi, welcome to this tutorial, and today after talking about data type, comments and identifiers, we are going to launch with this new topic, that is variables. The variables, what are the variables? Variables are actually defined as a portion of a memory to store a value. So you take a variable as a portion of the memory. So that portion of the memory need to have a name, and that name is the identifier. So a variable is a storage location that is a name storage location with identifier, and that so that it can be used to in our program. So when we reserve a memory location, we give it identifier, we can use the whole thing now in the program, that is called the variables. And to declare the variables, we have to specify the data type to see which amount of memory can be assigned to, which size of the memory can be assigned to the reserve memory, and then here identifier to name it so that we can use it in the program. So here when we go here in our program here, so where is the variable? This one, my ID here, is the variable, and what we are actually saying is that the computer to reserve a memory location of type integer, and then we name that memory location my ID, and now we can assign some values to this variable and use it. When we pass a value, it is stored in the memory, and a variable can be assigned a value, and when we do it the first time, we can say that it is initialized. You can just write equal like this one and zero, and we can have in a single line many declaration at the same time. So here is a variable declaration, integer variable declaration. You can also declare something like a character, my character, anything like a. This is a here that we have just declared, and now we declare it, now we are actually saving. Now we can use it later on in our program, like this one, my my ID. Now suppose we say that it is equal 110. Now when we run our program here, now you can see hello world 110, that is written. So here is our variable. So variable is this powerful thing that allow a computer to perform stuffs, a lot of comments. So remember, the computer is powerful because it can keep, it has a very big memory, it can keep stuff that we cannot. So that's it. Stay tuned.